Look at the juice bottles on top of the bar. Look at the stickiness on that bar.
You can see the syrups underneath the bar mats.
This place is disgusting.
Very sticky looking
back
there.
You can smell it from here.
Look at this kitchen. Look at the wall under the hood.
Oh, looks like it was never cleaned.
Stained. I've never seen anything like it.
I thought that's supposed to be stainless steel. What is all that crap all over it?
I'm not sure you can even clean that anymore, Vic.
You're gonna have to throw it away.
Deny. What do you have here, sir?
So, Phil, the bartenders are having shots.
They just started their shift. What are they doing?
Willie's drinking a beer. So, what happens 3 hours from now?
Willie, it's another bottle gone.
That explains why a lot of things are not done, right? Because they probably will stay exhausted by the end of the shift.
Probably if they can even see straight at the end of the shift.
Yep.
Another one? Come on. Round it up, round it up, round it up, round it up.
Oh, they're taking another shot?
One.
Bloody Mary's going hot sauce in them, right?
Yeah, that's the best. Is that a pre-miss?
It's a
right
pre-miss. I'm about to hook you up.
It's gonna have some bite.
It's gonna have some bite, and you know what? Instead of making the drink correctly, she's just adding to it.
Oh, what a look on his face.
What it tastes like?
Not it.
You know what's amazing to me? I have arranged for a couple of radio people to come do recon here. But you know what, guys? I'm gonna do recon myself. I want you guys to sit here, watch me. I'm gonna go in and do recon myself. I wanna see if Willie will do anything.
All right, let's see how long it takes for Willie to come greet Jon Taffer in your bar.
Willie's frozen.
Get your ass up off the bar, Willie. What are you doing? What is happening right now?
A few minutes to thaw out.
Do I have to come over there to get something, or do you guys come to me if I want to order?
When John walked in, I absolutely didn't notice him, but then as soon as it was made to my acknowledgement, I was like, oh, snap.
What's your name?
Alana.
Hi, Alana. So I want you to do something for me.
Okay.
I want you to get a pad and a pen and come back, because I'm going to order a bunch of stuff.
All right.
Okay.
You want to be on your own?
You're right.
So I want to try nachos, chicken potato skins.
All right.
What's Willie doing? Willie, anybody home?
There's no fire in him at all. Look at him.
Don't tell the cook this is for me. Just put the order in, okay?
Gotcha.
Thank you.
You can read his mind. Like, you know what he's saying right now.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's like, okay, what else is going on in here?
Where's Willie?
Where did Willie go? Oh, he's going in the kitchen.
Uh-oh. You seen Willie?
Probably had to complain. I mean,
Willie, how are you, sir?
Good.
Is your name Brian?
It is.
Is this your kitchen?
It is.
Gentlemen, this might be one of the dirtiest kitchens I've ever seen in my life. This is Vic Vegas, one of the best chefs in America and a restaurant owner. Look at this freaking place. Drop that basket in for me. That's motor oil.
Black bean soup.
I want to see what's in here.
Hey, what's shaking with that?
What the hell is...
Oh, my God.
Have you ever seen anything like that in your life? Okay, so this is garbage. Let me take the garbage. And let's start filling this cart with it. What else we got down there, Vic?
All right, well, here we go.
And what are these?
Those are our
what
wings.
What are these, Brian? Come
those
on, talk
wings.
To me.
Those are my wings.
Those are your wings. When were these cooked?
2 days ago.
Oh, my God.
These were cooked by him days ago. Should these be covered?
They should be.
How long have you been in the kitchen for? That's all I want to know.
25 years.
So 25 years. So why don't you cover stuff, man? It's what if you were off the next day? Somebody comes in, the wings are a little old. They mix new ones together. That's how people get sick.
Look at this
in place.
Who you yelling at, man?
I'm yelling at you.
Don't yell at me. You don't know me like that. Don't yell at me.
I will talk to you any freaking. Look at this.
You won't.
I don't have to speak. That does, doesn't it, Willie?
It does.
Now, this is your life. Get angry. What do you think about that? Say it.
It's disgusting.
It wasn't there yesterday.
Really? There's no logic here. You guys figure it out, Willie. He and you need to clean this kitchen tonight. I won't touch this place like this. Figure it out together, or you're gone. Oh, gee. Fix it, or get the f*** out of here.
Tyler, you good?
We've got one order of chicken fingers left.
What do you think about the exposed armpits? Would you allow that in your kitchen?
Absolutely not, and it's a health violation.
Hey, did we not place an order for chicken tenders?
So there's Candace.
Monday, we didn't add any.
I need to take the breast out of the freezer.
Oh.
That's the problem.
Complete rookie stuff. We can see the disorganization already.
So what, we can get it out now and thaw it?
It's not gonna fly out like that.
Wow.
Hi, honey, how are you? What you drinking, Mama?
Could I have a drink menu, please?
I don't have one.
Oh, no drink menu?
If you're wanting ones, I can do your martinis. Just your simple ones.
Can you make a ranch water?
Yeah.
I'll have that.
Thoughts on the rim or no?
Yes.
What kind of bourbon drinks do you have?
Ooh, just your one and ones. I don't have any simple bitters, any of that to make old fashions, and I really would not do a Manhattan here, to be honest.
You got a sweet tea or lemonade?
I do have lemonade. You want to do that?
Yeah, can I do a bourbon lemonade?
Just the house?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was kind of a weird vibe all the way around. Didn't really have that sports bar feel.
No drink menu. That's interesting. I could not see Rangers fans or Cowboys fans watching a game here unless they drastically change the environment. Maybe better drinks would also change the environment.
Strong.
He's puckering up.
I need to stir it up a little bit more. That's not great.
The first 3 minutes are not going well, are they?
You guys doing all right?
I think we're ready to order some food.
What can I get for you?
I'm gonna try the cowboy burger.
Okay. How about for you, sweetie?
I'll have the catfish platter with hush puppies.
Catfish platter with hush puppies, that sounds good.
Thank you.
Awesome, you're welcome.
Okay, let's keep an eye on Cook here, Chef, okay?
Yeah, no gloves.
All right, what do you need help with, Tyler?
Yeah, they have no system in place.
Where's the other wings?
That's the last bag of wings right there, too. They didn't come on the order.
This isn't even enough for the tickets that you have up here.
I know this because I didn't get to see any of these tickets.
All right, let's just count it out.
So unorganized.
That's the one where we said we were out of chicken tenders and he ordered it. So I said I told Candace we didn't need it because he ended up getting his chicken tenders.
Okay, so we don't need this?
No.
Wow.
If we don't have chicken tenders, can we have chicken breast? Can we make
that for another order?
For Will and Candace, they have different ways of doing business, but I think that Will could communicate a little bit better to help Candace.
Oh my God.
Why are we making wings that we don't need when wings are in short supply?
I don't know where he got those.
This is remarkable.
It's complete chaos.
We haven't served it. Okay. But they haven't been served.
Right, well. You can't reuse wings.
Okay.
I can't take this much more. Nick still doesn't have his food. He's not gonna have his food for a half hour.
He's giving me a headache.
Who is the
kitchen.
Now, what is Will doing?
Why doesn't he jump back there? I mean, you know, as the owner.
How about that burger for the cronk?
He's doing it right now.
The rest of the food's been out 20 minutes. You gotta try harder.
I'm not cooking it. My burger.
This is embarrassing.
I mean, they've been open for, what, a year? And it's like it's their first frickin' day.
Hey. This is hilarious.
I would say slow down the food orders, but I don't.
I mean, they're not even busy.
And there he is grabbing the raw ingredients with his bare hands.
Look at the,
Oh my God. And he just wipes it on his, look at that. He grabbed the plate. Oh my God.
Let's go inside. I want to stop them.
Yeah.
That food's not going out.
Stop! You picked up that bacon with your bare hands, then put your hands all over this plate. You're gonna kill somebody. You put gloves on your hand. Go don't touch raw chicken, then touch every handle in this kitchen. What the hell are you guys doing? Should you be touching raw bacon and then a plate and then food? Should you be?
No.
Are you gonna get somebody sick if you do that?
Possibly.
Possibly. Come here. Have you ever cooked before in your life?
Yeah.
Is it legal to wear that shirt in the kitchen?
I guess not.
You find that funny? Because you're not coming in like that tomorrow while I'm here, and you're not doing anything you did tonight while I'm here.
There's the bar. It's authentic Mexican.
Okay.
You know what's interesting? If you look in the room, and this is a great thing about Mexican restaurants, because you drink margaritas and you have cocktails with a Mexican meal.
Yes.
So they have good potential here.
Mm-hmm. I think I'll do the mezcal margarita.
Okay. The paloma, tequila with lime juice and triple sec.
No, there is no triple sec in a paloma. Okay, that is not real lime juice. The only thing authentic about that is the lime wheel. It was no fresh ingredients whatsoever.
Here you go, guys.
Thank you.
Mezcal margarita and paloma for you.
Thank you.
Excuse me, you want me to leave one menu on it?
How's that drink?
I should have told him to make it a double. Barely. I mean, if I was, you know how when you're a young kid and your dad let you sip a taste of beer, it tastes like that, like they put a drop of tequila in there.
So it's not right then?
No, it's not strong enough. Unless the tequila just got a whole bunch of sugar in it.
Oh, he doesn't like that at all.
Yeah.
He's puckering up from that.
Is this supposed to have like grapefruit?
No grapefruit.
It's like kind of too strong.
If you don't like it, I can change it for you, sir.
Yeah, can you make it a little bit
less alcohol for you?
Yes.
Sure, you got it.
May I have another margarita?
Sure, you want the same, the mezcal one?
No, that one didn't have enough alcohol in it. I don't know what's good. I want to taste the good stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just feel like I want to run and try. It's just, it's overwhelming.
Carne asada, cuatro camarones, four shrimps.
30 minutes and nothing has come out just yet. Nothing.
Go.
No.
She looks a little stressed, doesn't she?
It's not even stressed.
Holy shit.
Dress it up. Dress it up. Yo le pongo todo.
Now, this cook doesn't know what he's doing, so I'm curious to see how this goes. If there's one thing that freaks me out, it's what?
Cleanliness.
Raw chicken.
Oh, jeez.
Look at this. Sorry. Look at the cross-contamination.
Same glove.
How do you like the chicken?
Look at him touching protein with his hands.
This is terrifying.
Oh. This is completely cross-contaminated. I have to go in this kitchen. Don't serve any food. You know who I am?
Yes, sir.
Do you want me to help you?
Yes.
Come with me. This man is gonna kill somebody.
Okay.
There's raw chicken on here, right? Now he has salad on it.
Okay.
He takes raw chicken, goes in the refrigerator, grabs all the food. All of this food is covered in raw chicken. None of this can be served. You think it's funny? Do you know that he's touching raw chicken with his hands and then grabbing salad and then touching meats with his hands?
Oh, my God.
What happens, Claudia?
Cross-contamination.
You can kill someone. Shut all this equipment off. I want to see you guys out front.
I'm super overwhelmed. Overwhelm is not even a word right now. I don't know what to do.
Like, look at that kitchen wall up there.
Oh, the mysterious yellow-brown rust color.
Now, that's dust and spider webs and everything on that wall. Right below that is an oven. And those are crisping pans with the dust all over them.
On the crisping pans.
On the crisping pan.
And then the food goes in those.
And that's the cooking environment.
Wow.
How many years have they gone without even trying to wipe that wall down?
My man, they've never cleaned that wall.
Anything you need, okay, back there?
Thank you.
Good.
There you go. Look at the cases of vodka standing behind him there. He doesn't even put his liquor away.
Oh, is that his liquor storage room?
That's his liquor storage.
Just abrasively out for the guests to see.
In the corner of the bar is the most valuable seats in the bar.
Yes. Wow.
Look at the juice bottles on top of the bar. Look at the stickiness on that bar.
You can see the syrups underneath the bar mats.
This place is disgusting.
Very sticky looking
back
there.
You can smell it from here.
Do you like a watermelon margarita?
I don't know if we have watermelon. Do you have raspberry?
Do you have raspberry?
Yeah.
Now look, she just asked for a watermelon margarita and call me crazy. In a perfect world, you're doing fresh watermelon, but I did see watermelon liquor on the back bar.
So she could have
made it. She could have made it.
Is it together? Are you gonna do cash?
Yeah, we'll do cash, please. Thank you.
See any smiles, any interaction? Yeah, wow, she looks like she's at a funeral, doesn't she?
She looks miserable.
Yeah, gotcha.
Is that funk in the soda gun?
It sure is.
No, that was bad.
That was bad.
Real bad.
Oh, it's okay. Thank you.
Thanks.
When she opened the ice well to get ice, I could have sworn I saw just a blackness, and I hope it's not mold.
Oh, man, if that's mold, then we can't let our bartenders have the cocktail.
When she was scooping ice to put into her well,
yeah,
that's where I saw it, so.
I'm going in, guys. First of all, I don't want you guys to drink that. Come with me, Rob.
You know, when I hear your story, and I hear how you love the community, mm-hmm. right, and how much this town means to you, and then I see things like filth that is unbelievable, that if you guys drink this, you will get sick. You know what this is? See those little chunks? Feces from cockroaches and fruit flies. So come with me, Rob. This is mold in this ice machine. This will get every single one of you sick. Now, you girls are bartenders. Would you work here knowing that?
Absolutely not.
So that's the filth just here. I mean, look at this freaking place. I mean, it's unbelievable. There's just junk everywhere. And I haven't even gone in a kitchen yet. So this is a guy who loves the community, but serves you bacteria. This is a guy who cares about his employees, right? But let you work in disgusting filth that is unbelievable. So do you care about this community? Or are you full of shit? Because somebody who cares doesn't do this. Right now, honestly, I despise what you represent in this industry. You're the guy who gets people sick. You're the guy who gives us a bad name. You're the guy who does everything in this industry that I freaking hate. So prove me wrong and clean this place tonight. And I'll come back here tomorrow morning with my chef and my mixologist. We will inspect this bar, we will inspect the kitchen, and if it isn't clean, I'm gone. And at least I left them with a cleaner place than when I got here, right? And that might be all you get out of me, is being forced to clean your bar.
Please, I wouldn't drink any more of that if you guys. I mean that very, very much.
Hi, this is Jon Taffer. Click here to subscribe to Paramount Network on YouTube for more Bar Rescue.